Someday, when I'm awfully low, when the world is cold.
Well, hello, everybody. Thank you so much for coming today. For those of you that don't know me, my name's Wendy Allman, and I'm Jerry and Edie's daughter. And my brother Scott is over there as well. And we're just so happy that you could come and celebrate Jerry and Edie's 50th wedding anniversary, 50 years of wedded bliss, right? Yeah. And we won't mention the argument you had when you got here about who was sitting where. So that's all. It's all good. But anyway, we're so happy that you could all be here. And for those of you who were placing bets on what was the small little gift at your place setting there, that is actually a vanilla-covered golden Oreo dusted in an edible gold. So it's not soap. So if you had soap, you're wrong. It's not soap. So yeah, take those with you and enjoy them. But anyway, I am going to invite Pastor Gary White to come up and ask the blessing before we eat. And once he's finished, actually, if you'll just stay seated, the staff here at the wonderful Hampton Banquet Hall will be coming around to dismiss tables. And there will still be whatever's left of hors d'oeuvres will still be up there. And if you hadn't had a chance to look at the cake, it's over here. They'll be cutting and serving that. And all the great pictures that are over here throughout the years of their wedding. So thank you, Pastor Gary.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your grace in each of our lives. And Father, we thank you that you have blessed us by giving us this opportunity today to be a part of this 50th wedding anniversary. Father, I personally have known Jerry and Edie for a number of years now. And Father, I am so grateful to you for the wonderful example they have been of a Christ-centered marriage. Lord Jesus, I praise you and I thank you for giving us the strength that we need in order to be faithful to our spouses. Father, we live in a world where there are so many allurements, where there are so many temptations. But Lord, you have told us how important the marriage covenant is. Father, thank you for giving us all the grace we need to stay faithful to the one that you have given to us. Father, be with all of us here this evening during this time together, this great luncheon. Lord, give it all of us a good time. And Lord, we thank you for this food that we're about to receive and for all of our blessings. Amen.
Dave Sly, I have something very important to tell you. DJ Mike Mason rules. That is all. Oh, congratulations, Jerry and Edie. 50 more. So long.
but I think that's over.
That's a good workaround, though.
That's a big cry.
Hey, Jerry, come here.
Yes, sir.
When are you coming back to KDKA?
Well, I think I'll wait until you retire, because they'll be down a weather person, so...
You're right. They'll need a new weather guy.
So maybe the job will be open.
Another bald weather guy.
I mean, hey, I can always say Squatty Showers. Squatty Showers.
Oh, that's right.
That's become the catchphrase in weather these days. Not scattered showers, but Squatty Showers.
Well, and if you want to be technical about it, Grisella uses the word spot. He doesn't even add the Y.
Well, that's because he's the chief meteorologist.
And he can do that.
He's allowed to do
that. Exactly right. Yeah.
He makes up his own terms.
He does. Hey, listen. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Debbie and I are right behind you. We're 43 this year.
Okay. Catching up.
So we'll be contacting you in 7 years and expect you to attend our ceremony.
Okay. Very good. Very
God bless you, too. It's awesome.
Who's behind me?
I just want to welcome everybody. I know that Wendy's done a great job of doing that already, but from the bottom of our hearts, Edie and I want to thank everybody for coming out. I know everybody has busy lives. This is what we wanted to do. We wanted to celebrate 50 years of our marriage by sharing it with people who have played various parts in our lives, some big, some small. But you're all here. You're all here for a reason, and we wanted you to have a good time. Thanks, Max. Thanks. That's why Max is at Geneva College, so he knows how to push the button on a computer. First off, I'd like to thank family members. You know, when you get older, sometimes your family members kind of disappear. And so we don't have a whole lot of family here today, but we do have some. You've seen and heard from Wendy. She's our daughter. Our son, Scott, who plays my body double in movies. Scott's wife, Jennifer. Our step-granddaughters, Alexis and Natalie. And Jennifer's parents, Terry and Joanne. And we're thankful that they're here with us today. And over at our table, besides Edie and I, we have Edie's cousin, John, and his daughter, Jeannie, and her husband, Andy. We have Joanne Nelson and Marilyn Williams, who went to school in Ross Draver Township, grade school and high school together. And we're glad that Joanne and Marilyn could be here today. They're great friends of Edie's, and they're really good people. And we appreciate them coming over from Ross Draver Township to be here. The other two couples that are sitting there, both those young ladies I grew up with. I knew my parents and her parents were good friends from the time we were little kids, Bonnie. And the other young lady sitting there, Kathy, we went from kindergarten through 12th grade. We went through Chatham Grade School and Perry High School on the north side together. And Kathy tells some very terrible stories about the two of us, but we won't get into that right now. If anybody feels faint today, don't worry, because we have quite a few nurses here today. Edie worked in the field of medicine. I worked in television. So there are at least 9 nurses here today. There is 1 nurse practitioner. I think there's also 1 physician assistant, and we have some of those ladies who have worked in hospital administration. So they're all here today. So if you have any medical needs, we got you covered. If you're interested in television, particularly in the area of production, a lot of those yahoos that were standing up here before are in that field. Many of us worked together in the studio at KDKA over the years in various capacities. Audio, camera, video, there's a lot of different areas there. Some of the folks are here from the news department, some from administration, We have Dennis Bowman, who used to be our weatherman, who is happily retired like I am now. We're happy that Dennis could be here. Dennis and I worked the last X number of years of my time at KDK. We were on the morning crew together. And so many of the folks from KDK, we worked together on the morning crew. And a lot of times people thought, oh, well, you just got up early in the morning to work. No, we got up in the middle of the night. I used to roll out of my driveway by 3:30 in the morning to be in the studio at 4 a.m. to go on air at 5 in those days. Nowadays, they go on even earlier. They go on at 4:30. So I appreciate what they do, and I appreciate all their friendships. We had, we experienced a lot of things over the years. It was a lot of fun to work with them. From the day I retired from KDK a little over 9 years ago, I have never missed working in television. As much as I loved working in television, I have never missed that, but I do miss the people that I worked with. Another group that's here, and a lot of these people are also kind of in that same group of the nurses, are Edie's Card Club, or a card club that Edie belongs to. And believe it or not, that card club has been in existence longer than Edie and I have been married, and she's been a part of that card club longer than we've been married. And it's a great group of ladies that are still together, and they have a lot of fun. From a church standpoint, there are a lot of people here that we have gone to church with over the years in different churches, and we've served in different capacities. We've served as elders together, we've served on church boards, and we've had a lot of fun doing it. Church isn't always serious. A lot of times it's just fun. And we've had a good time with all the people that are here. We also have with us today, scattered amongst you, four pastors are here today, and we thank them for coming and thank them for their time. We have a table over here of our neighbors. We actually have friends that are our neighbors. And we appreciate them coming. And last but not least, some of these people are also entwined in church. But I just wanted to highlight the fact that there's a great many people here today that were part of the Glenshaw Lions softball team. And there's a little picture over on the table. That's just one of the years that we played. And the interesting thing was that it was a great time together. And we all had a lot of fun. We all played different roles on the team. But the most important person on our team was my wife, Edie. And you might ask why, because she was our scorekeeper. And if you ask our coach, Bob Arnold, who's here today, Bob will tell you that she was the most important person on our team. And when I retired from softball, Bob could have cared less that I was leaving, but he knew he was losing his scorekeeper too. And he's never forgiven me for that. A quick Reader's Digest version, as fast as I can. It all began on October 29th, 1966, at a Halloween party, no less. Now, you've heard that I work in television, and Edie worked as a nurse in a hospital, Allegheny General at the time. We had a director. I worked at Channel 11 my first 2 years in television. We had a director. His name was Lou Vlahos. He was an early version of Danny DeVito. He was about this tall. He was a ball of fire, he had unboundless energy, and he was also quite a ladies' man. Well, during the 11 o'clock news in September of 1966, during ratings, you can all identify with that, people who work in television, Lou was directing 11 o'clock news, and under, I'm sure, a lot of pressure at the time, trying to keep up with the ratings of KDKA, Lou had a heart attack. He was rushed to Allegheny General Hospital. The good news was he survived. While he was a patient at Allegheny General, he, as I mentioned before, was a ladies' man, struck up a conversation with a number of the nurses. And he talked to one of the nursing supervisors, and he found out that she was having a Halloween party at her house in Pleasant Hills. She said to Lou, "Do you know any guys at Channel 11 that are single?" And he said, "Oh, yeah, there's 7, 8, 9 guys up that are single." He said, "Well, tell them that, you know, they're invited to come to our party." So we weren't too excited about it, the guys at Channel 11. Most of us said we weren't going to go. And at the last minute, about 7 of us did decide to go. Edie, on the other hand, on the other side of the coin, she also really wasn't interested in going. She said she wasn't going to go. But at the last minute, she decided to go. The rest is history. We didn't want to come in costume. They came in costume. Most of the nurses came in costume. I was looking as people were walking into the family room of this house, and I noticed that, Edie, would you stand up for a second? I noticed from across the room that she was about as short as she is right now sitting in a chair. And I thought to myself, she was dressed up like a little old lady. And she had some sort of mask on, so I couldn't really see her face. But I thought, just the way she was moving, the way she looked, and the fact that she was short, and because I'm obviously vertically challenged, I looked at that and I said, wow, there's somebody I'd like to talk to. So later, after the judging of the costumes, they were allowed to change back into their regular clothes. And when she came back into the room, she sat down. Unfortunately, she sat down next to a friend of mine from the station who immediately struck up a conversation. Now, his name was Joe, and Joe was kind of a gullible guy, and Joe had actually driven me to the party. And I thought to myself, I'm sitting next to Joe, and Edie's on the other side, and I'm thinking, how do I get rid of Joe? So I looked at Joe, and I said, Joe, you know, I left something in your car. Would you mind getting it for me? And instead of him handing me the keys and saying, get it yourself, he got up and went to get it for me. By the time he came back, we were pretty much on our way to our first date. Unfortunately, I had a date with Uncle Sam later in the month of November for basic training at Fort Jackson, South Carolina. So we dated fast. We did kind of like speed dating, and we had a few dates. And I was getting ready to leave for Fort Jackson, and I said to Edie, I said, well, you'll have to write me. And she said, you know, I'm not much of a letter writer. And I said, well, you know, but yeah, I'm gonna be lonely, I'm gonna be away from home. You gotta write me. She said, well, I don't count on it. So the first week I'm at Fort Jackson, a letter comes from Edie, and I thought, yeah, that's not bad. First week I got a letter. And the second week, two letters came from Edie. And the third week, three letters came from Edie. And from that point on, almost every week, there were two or three letters. So I knew, I thought, we haven't known each other that long, but I've got a good thing going here. So when I was back from active duty, and a little less than 2 years later after we had met, on September 7th, 1968, in a far-off galaxy called Manesson, Pennsylvania, in St. Paul's Lutheran Church at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. She made me the happiest man in the world. Some of you may be old enough, I am, some of you may be old enough to remember the old comedian, Henny Youngman. He talked real fast, had a lot of corny jokes. But he was asked one time, what was the secret to his long marriage? And he said, we take the time to go to a restaurant 2 times a week, a little candlelight, dinner, soft music, and dancing. She goes Tuesdays and I go Fridays. Now, that's not the way it is for Edie and I. We're pretty inseparable, and we've been pretty inseparable actually for the last 52 years since we met. I kind of like what theologian Martin Luther said about marriage. He said, there's no more lovely, friendly, and charming relationship, communion, or company than a good marriage. The other evening, Edie and I were sitting in a family room, and I looked at her and I said, what do you think, what can we say about the success of our 50 years together? We both agreed that first and foremost was our faith in God that came first. We both came from loving families, and our parents gave us a great example of a strong marriage bond. And finally, no matter how many bumps in the road, we were always committed to each other. And I thank God for that. So this afternoon, we thank you for taking the time to celebrate our 50th anniversary with us. And we want to God bless you for coming to be a part of it.
So we wanted to open the mic, and it's portable, so I can bring it around. If anybody else wanted to share a story or anything about Jerry and Edie, we'd be happy to do that. So I'm happy to grab the mic and run, or you can come up here, whatever you'd like to do. Oh, there we go. All right. Awesome. Here we go.
Hi, Jerry. I used to work with Jerry early in the mornings, running from the newsroom, working on the assignment desk to do prompter, and Jerry was the camera operator. Now, during those long hours in between commercial breaks, Jerry and I would discuss politics, family, relationships, and of course, my favorite was the relationships. And I said, Jerry, I can't find a good guy. He said, why are you looking for him? He's supposed to find you. That's what I did with my wife. And I'm like, okay, Jerry, so how can I find a good guy? And he looked at me, didn't I tell you he needs to find you? That's what I did. And since that time, I have always listened to you in regarding to what a good family man is, what a good friend is, and I'm just so thankful for having you in my life and introducing me to Yvette, who told me I need to get a cat. At some point I'll get that cat, but in the meantime, congratulations, happy 50th.
There we go.
I did not want to be first. Thank you for doing that. But you did such a good job, I don't think I'm going to talk. No, actually, I just want to thank Jerry and Edie for being there for me at a very difficult time in my life. They both had a quiet ministry of reaching out to hurting people who were in difficult situations and being a special friend and just helping us to believe that we're going to get through this and things are going to get better, and sure enough, they did. And just for Scott and Wendy, a remembrance that I have is Jerry and Edie took us to, I think it was the Ice Capades, and Scott and Wendy couldn't get along with each other. So the highlight of the night, I think, was when they said, Bev, would you sit between the two kids? And that was my contribution to the Swedler happiness. Thank you so much.
That's good. I remember that. This went from a talkative group to a quiet group. Goodness. All right. I don't remember that, Bev, but I'm sure it's true because, yeah. Scott and I still don't always get along, but that's okay. It's all good. Thanks.
All right. I'm Kathy Pollan, and yes, Jerry and I went to school from K through 12. Now, I'd like to make a confession, and Jerry knows what it's going to be because I've done this to him several times. Jerry was the first guy I ever slept with. This is my husband, I'm sorry. That's because in kindergarten, we took naps. Thank you for those memories, Jerry.
Yeah. I'm sorry I slept right through.
Was it good for you as it was for me?
Well, I know Jerry through Kathy, and the one thing that stands out in my mind is how gracious and good he was to Kathy's mother, my mother-in-law. He would come and see her, he and Kate, Edie. She lived almost 100 years old, and she so looked forward to both of you coming. And it was a highlight of her day or of her month, and I will always appreciate. And you're the type of guy that stays with people you know, from grade school all the way through whatever. I don't think I even remember the names of anybody I knew in high school. In fact, we went to a high school reunion. I went to high school in Fort Cherry High School, and they all thought she was the student. So I thought, well, that's okay. They didn't know who I was, and they kept saying, remember we had so much good time back there at Fort Cherry? She'd never been to the school. But Jerry, thank you for Mrs. P. She was one of my most favorite persons in the world, and Edie too.
Thank you. Well, working on the KDKA morning show, I was always the first one in the studio. I would get up at 1:50 a.m. and I would arrive at a little after 3, and then after me, the next person who would show up would always be Jerry. Jerry came in, he'd get the coffee started, and we got to have always a nice little conversation at about 3:45 or 4 a.m. Is that when, it's about no later than 4 is when you came in, right? So we would have a nice little conversation there. The other thing I noticed is that when I started working on the morning show, I'm sharing space at the desk with 20-somethings and 30-somethings, and then there's me. And once in a while, I would forget who I was sitting with and who my audience was, and I would start talking about things from 55, 60 years ago. And one time I said, there's a lot of Hayes out there in Pittsburgh today, and I'm not talking about Gabby Hayes either. And then I looked over at my 20-something and 30-something mates. I said, you know who Gabby Hayes is, of course. And I got stares. And I took it a step further, and I said, you know, he always had whiskers on, his hat was turned back, and he'd say, why, you dirty rotten cracker. And they're still staring at me. And this is, did I mention this is on television? This is on the air. But I hear one laugh going on, and it's Jerry up there where the cameras are. He's getting it, you know, and so he comes up to me afterwards and says, I just want you to know, nobody else knew who Gabby Hayes was, but I do. Every time I would slip up and come up with something from ancient history, I knew I had an audience of one, and it was always Jerry. So Jerry, we go way back there. It was always great to have that friendship with you. And I mentioned to Jerry when I came in, I read the other day that there is a statistic that says that only 5% of marriages make it to 50 years. We have a shining example of those that do. And thank you very much, Jerry and Edie. God bless you. And thank you very much for the friendship. All right.
I've known Edie for a long time because we went to high school together. And then we went to nursing school together. So I've known her a long time. But I just wanted to tell you one thing. This man that everybody's saying how kind and gentle and so forth, he nearly knocked my nose off. Right? Yeah. We played basketball together. And he was coming up and I was coming down. That was it. He is a kind gentleman. No. Thank you. I've enjoyed knowing you all these years.
Turn the music back up a little bit, please. Oh, sorry. Oh, there we go, Vicky. Sorry.
Okay. Just a thank you to you, Jerry. All the notes and all the cards for my daughter, and sorry I'm emotional. A happy emotional. She was an addict for 24 years, and probably about 10 years of Jerry praying. And not only is she clean and sober 2 years, but she's a director of a woman's faith-based recovery home in California. So God is good, and thanks for all those prayers.
So my name is Mike. I work with Jerry, but not for a very long time. But we, KDK Radio and TV, used to have a softball team together. So that's first where I met Jerry when I was working at KDK Radio. Then I went away to Fox for 9 years, and once everyone got laid off there because they didn't have a news anymore, I came back to KDK, and television had hired me. So I came in as an audio operator. Audio is all I ever really knew in radio or television. Well, when I came to KDKA, I did a little bit of audio. Then they stuck me in this place called projection. So projection's not a bad job, but I thought, can I do something else? So I begged my boss, Jeff, please let me do something else. All right, we're going to put you on the morning show, and Jerry is going to teach you how to run cameras. So I went down, and I have to say I was a little intimidated at first because on the softball field, you were really good and whatever. And I thought, oh, is Jerry mean? What's going to be like? But he taught me to run cameras. He was very patient. And then I think I remember Jerry always took 3 weeks of vacation. And I think it was called the Summer of Jerry or something like that. Was that what it was called? So every Summer of Jerry, I got to go down and run cameras for 3 weeks. But I really enjoyed you being patient with me. And when I messed something up, you didn't get all over me about it. So congratulations on 50 years. And would anybody else like the microphone? Now he has a constant Summer of Jerry.
When I started at KDKA, I was in a different area, not in the studio. And at some point, about 6 years into my employment there, I was reassigned to the studio. And Jerry was always welcoming from the first day to the new guy. And I always would appreciate that. But the one thing I wanted to talk about is all those years that we worked in the morning together. Jerry and I were looking for the cheapest place to park, and it certainly wasn't downtown. So we spent all those years parking over somewhere on the north side. Before the new stadiums were built, we'd be in a parking lot. And as the stadiums got built in the late 90s, we got chased farther and farther away to the point that we were parking at Allegheny Center, which is now Nova Place, and walking across. All types of weather, it'd be 90 degrees in the summer, it would be zero with a cold wind blowing across 6th Street Bridge in the winter, and we'd be in parkas and hoods and everything. But what I really cherished about those 20 minutes that we would walk across was I had two young girls growing up at the time, and Jerry always had words of wisdom about about raising children, dealing with the sports leagues and the education and their faith and raising them the right way. And I always knew that that came from Jerry and Edie's their marriage and the strength of their marriage and the beliefs that they had and the right way to raise a family. And it's made a difference in my family's life for sure.
Hi, I'm Patty, and I've worked with Jerry for many, many years, back when Jerry edited film for Time. Is that what it was? You always edited for the breaks? So I would come on duty at 4 in the morning, and I would go up and I would run these films. And occasionally, they're old black and white films, and they were brittle. Every once in a while, the film would break. So the guys in Master Control, Otis, I don't know where he went, he worked in Master Control, they always said, grab the the film from the feed and just pull down a whole bunch of film and rip it off and then go ahead and feed it through, and that will make up minutes. So, okay, I did this many times. I took the broken film and I'd wrap it all up, the piece I tore off, put it in a box, send it back with the film to Jerry. And this went on for I don't know how long, and one day Jerry came upstairs and he said, "Who told you to do that?" And I said, "The guys in Master Control told me to do that." And he says, "Don't."
Okay, I was thinking of whether to say this or not, but I'm going to. Now, in this political climate, you know, people are being very nasty to one another. And I'll tell you, Jerry and I come from different backgrounds. Do we, Jerry? Okay. And one of the great things I think with my friendship with Jerry, especially in those mornings, were the fact that we could have those arguments, those disagreements, and I'm a diabetic, and once he starts seeing my sugars going down, Jerry will run, "She needs a Snickers bar." And Jerry will run and go over into the snack room and get me that Snickers bar. And that's the type of man Jerry is, and the fact that he could tell a joke in such a manner, make you laugh, and still argue with you at the same time, that's Jerry.
Well, thank you all again so much for your fun, kind words. And hey, I've done that walk across the bridge. It sucks. So yeah, that's good. But thank you all again for coming out and celebrating Jerry and Edie and their 50 years of marriage. They're a great example to us, to Scott and I, our respective spouses and our kids as well. And we appreciate all of that. And a lot of kind words for them, and that's they deserve every single one of those. We appreciate them for how they raised us, what they taught us. We learned to be pretty tough when you grow up in a house with a mom who's an ER nurse. She, you know, you got to be dying before you get any attention. So you learn to shake it off, right? Yeah, shake it off, get back out there, it's all good. So we appreciate that. And that's kind of carried over Max right into, yeah, exactly, shake it off, get out there. Also, our family love of hockey, the sport of hockey, which my parents, you know, instilled in us. That was a sport that we enjoyed watching growing up and got to go to games. And so that was important. And again, passed on down through that. So that love, and Scott, you'll back me up on this, that love of hockey runs in the family, practically gallops. Yeah, so it's a good thing. And old movies, Cary Grant movies, I think we appreciate. Old Cary Grant movies because of my dad's love for old movies and working with film in the early days there at Channel 11 and then KDKA especially. So we thank them for that, and we hope that they have many, many more. My mom is a saint. She has survived 9 years of my dad's retirement, and we have not had to dip into the bail money fund yet, so it's a good thing. It's a good thing. So thanks for coming. Enjoy. There's going to be cake that's going to be served here. We're going to crank the music back up a little bit. Please enjoy visiting with them and each other, and thank you again for coming.